Good morning, everybody, and welcome to a new week at Oxford. I've actually already been to the Taylorian this morning to get some shots done for the videos that I'm doing for the practicum and to get some stuff done for that. And then I did some grocery shopping, came back here, got the videos put together and everything. I don't have a crazy amount to get done at the start of this week, but I have a few things that I just want to get ahead on. So I'm going to be working on that today, and yeah, nothing crazy planned for today, but I have a lot of fun stuff coming up throughout the week, so I'm very excited for that. It should be quite cool. And yeah, it's no longer sunny. We had a very, very warm weekend. I did burn myself. However, I think it's getting a lot better. It's still kind of red, but not as like aggressive as it was before. But yeah, it's back to overcast and kind of windy today, which is too bad, but I'm sure we'll get more. It was like full-on summer weather this weekend. I'm sure we'll get more of that in the next couple of weeks. So yeah, off to a good start. Good morning, everybody. So yesterday was quite uneventful. I mostly just worked at home during the day, but today I have hair appointment coming up, which is quite cool. I'm going to Kelly's Hair. This is the first time I've actually gotten my hair cut since I've been at Oxford. I let Eloise trim my ends. She'd always wanted to cut someone's hair, and I was like, I'll let you trim my hair. If you watch a full tutorial on YouTube, she watched like 30 seconds of it and was like, I got it. And then she trimmed my ends, and it turned out fine. She turned out was fair play. I got to trim her hair as well. I trim my own bangs, and I have trimmed my sister's ends before during COVID when all the salons were shut down, and like, it wasn't a disaster. But yeah, I really need a haircut. So I'm going to, yeah, Kelly's Hair. It was honestly just one of the more, it's still expensive, but like, every salon here is kind of crazy. Like, they'll charge up to £75 just for a cut, and I think this is more common in bigger cities, but they're like, cut only, like, no style, you have to pay more for that, whereas, like, every salon I've been to back home was, like, it's just automatically included that they're gonna, like, straighten or curl it or blow dry it. Like, this was, like, you'll get a rough blow dry, maybe, and I was, like, okay, interesting, because they'll be, like, it's crazy. Some of them, for just a cut, was, yeah, up to £75, which, if you convert it to Canadian, is close to what I was paying for, like, a color cut. And then she would usually style it after. The only time that she ever didn't was because, like, for some reason my color just ran way longer than usual, and we were, like, going into the next person's appointment, so she was getting quite behind, so yeah, she didn't, like, curl it or anything, which is fine. But it's just interesting to me that, like, you'd have to pay extra for, like, a very simple style. I get, like, if you're doing an updo or something crazy, but, like, it's just different. And before I came over, we'd been talking, and my sister was like, oh, it'd be so cool to, like, get your hair done in London or whatever. And I haven't even looked up London salon prices, but if they're that high in Oxford, probably not. But I'm very excited to get my hair cut. My bangs, I've let them get quite long because I knew that I was going to get my hair cut, and they're irritating me, so I'm excited to get it all done. But yeah, I'm about to head out there now, and then I don't know what I'm gonna do. Maybe go to the Radcam or a cafe or something. We'll see. Hey guys, so I'm back from my hair appointment, and then afterwards I was at the library for an hour or two. And yeah, I'm really happy with it. It is not a particularly dramatic change, but like, we added some shorter layers around my face, which I like. Now when I put it up, I can do the little pieces like everybody does. And yeah, so like I was saying earlier, they do just blow it dry normally, which for the price, because so Kelly's Hair does I think 20% student discount on, it's either Monday through Wednesday or Monday through Thursday. So with the discount total, it wound up being £30, which is like, yeah, the best deal I could find for a salon in Oxford. So that's pretty good. I will say, if I was paying like £75 for just a trim, I'd probably be like, You can't throw a little mousse or a curl in there when you're done. But for this, I was, quite perfectly happy with it. And I really like the cut, and I, it's what I wanted. It was just simple, and the ends feel nicer because I haven't gotten it cut since, like, September. So it feels much better, and my bangs are not quite as crazy anymore. And she did say if you, like, need your fringe cut or whatever, you can just pop in and they'll do it for free in between appointments, which is really nice because that's why I trim it myself, because back home I was like, I'm not popping in and paying, like, $10 every time. I just want my bangs cut, so I just started doing it myself. So yeah, I'm quite happy with it. I feel like it has way more, like, shape and movement when it's down. So I'm happy, would recommend. But yeah, now I'm need to do some laundry because I have quite a bit built up. So I'm just gonna do that and continue working here. I have to film a video for the Kafka exhibition. So yeah, got a few things to do today, but should be good. It is. Hello guys, it's just past 7:30 now. The day kind of got away from me, at least in terms of filming. I was just doing laundry and doing work here. So I've been sort of cleaning up my intro with the suggestions that my supervisor had made. And then I was also like fixing all of the data, like just not like fixing it, but like making sure that each time I like filled in a section that I filled it in the same order for like the TikTok sort of data that I'd collected so that I can also send that to him. So that's kind of what I was working on today. But then also Eloise had messaged and asked if any of us wanted to go for a walk. So I was like, I'll go for a walk. But we wound up at Knoop's getting iced chocolate again. And then we cut back through the mall and she wound up shopping. She bought some different shoes because she doesn't have any sandals. I didn't even buy anything. So like, good on me. But yeah, so we had an impromptu shopping trip for her. And yeah, that's been my day so far. Unfortunately, so the college is doing the Maudlin exchange today. So because for like the college formal dinner exchanges, and that's the one that I had applied for and didn't get on because it was really popular. So they're having the home leg tonight because they had the away leg a few nights ago. So it's kind of sad because I wasn't getting to go to that. But I will survive. It's okay. They said they had an interesting tour of the Maudlin grounds that the people giving the tour were entertaining, so. But it's okay. I can just go walk around Maudlin on my own. But yeah, other than that, I'm just gonna have a chill night in. So yeah, tomorrow will be quite fun. I won't spoil it now, but it's going to be weird. So, or not weird, but like, well, it's kind of a weird thing, and like, you'll get the gist tomorrow. Hello everybody, so as promised, I'm going to talk about the slightly weird but cool thing that I'm doing today. Basically, all of the Canadian Rhodes Scholars got invited to a lunch and an afternoon tea. So we're having lunch at John McCall McBain's residence in London, and then tea at the House of Lords afterwards. So McCall McBain is a former Rhodes Scholar. He's a Canadian billionaire. And I think he started kind of in finance stuff and then moved into, I think he bought a bunch of like print houses, got into printing, and he does a lot of charity work. He's a huge donor to the trust. Like the main event room in Rhodes House right now is called the McCall McBain Room. And he actually started his own a scholarship called the McCall McBain Scholarship to McGill in Quebec, and it's a fully funded graduate scholarship. I think they pay all of your fees. You also get a living stipend. And then they have like a lot of programming throughout the year. Like I think you get put in a cohort and you do a bunch of sort of development stuff throughout the year. I don't know like all the super specific details about that scholarship, of course, because I'm not currently on it. So I don't know all of the ins and outs. But yeah, it was just for Canadians for a while. But I believe this year is the first year that they have international scholarships as well. So quite cool, kind of similar to the Rhodes Scholarship, actually. But yeah, still a huge donor to the Rhodes Trust now. And I think it's really cool that he's Canadian and that it's like the McCall McBain Room at Rhodes House because, you know, the Rhodes Scholarship is so international. And I feel like American Rhodes is really, really well known internationally, at least North America, like, people associate roads with American roads and American politics because so many famous American politicians and political journalists are Rhodes Scholars. So I think it's quite cool that it's, like, a Canadian that's a pretty big deal around Rhodes House. But yeah, I'm very excited. I think this is going to be quite a cool experience. The invite said business casual, but, like, it's luncheon and afternoon tea, so I was like, I'm not gonna dress like it's an interview or, you know, it's just like, what should I wear for this thing? So I wore this shirt dress from Banana Republic, because I feel like it's collared, so it's businessy, but it's appropriate for tea. That was my line of thinking. But yeah, I don't think I'm going to be able to, like, film much from today, maybe a little bit in the House of Lords, we'll see, but I will recap the day afterwards. Hello everybody, it's the next day now. So, like I said yesterday, I didn't think I was gonna get many clips, and I didn't. I think I put in a couple from different areas in the House of Lords. There was one room, I took like a couple clips there, but there was one specific room. Like, so prior to this room, other people, including myself, had been like taking a couple photos, and then we went in this one room, and I don't really know what the significance is, to be honest, but I got gently scolded for taking pictures. So, but then after that room and other rooms, other people were taking pictures as well. So I'm not totally sure, like, where was okay to take pictures and where wasn't. So I think I might just, like, not put, have put any in just in case we weren't supposed to take anything there. Because whoops. And I don't want to be, like, you know, thrown in jail. So yeah, but I had a nice time. We had lunch at the John McCormick Bain and his wife's home. She was really, really interesting. She's works in more like medical sciences at Oxford, actually, and she's, yeah, is still in academia. And they do a lot of different, like, charity work and foundation work. And then there's also Lord Wasserman, who's also a former Canadian Rhodes Scholar and is, like, now a Lord, which is quite cool. And he hosted the afternoon tea at the House of Lords, but he was also at lunch and everything. And then there were some other people that, one of the guys had also gone to Oxford, and that's how he met John McCormick Bain, and, like, works with a bunch of people that, like, work with the McBains, basically, were there. So it was really nice. It was a really nice time. They were very, very welcoming and very nice, and it's really cool that they continue to do that every year for the Canadian Rhodes Scholars. It's just, like, a cool experience to have had. And, like, I personally don't hobnob with a lot of billionaires, so I thought it was quite interesting to listen to him talk and, like, hear their perspectives on things. So yeah, had a nice time, but then got home. We, like, so after the House of Lords, we were, you know, sent off. So we went and had a drink at this boat that's, like, a bar on the river, like, quite close, like, across from the London Eye, kind of, like, by the House of Lords, basically. And we, yeah, hung out there for a bit and then headed home, but we stopped at, like, a little restaurant and had pizza and pasta before catching the train home. So I think we got back, like, close to 10-ish, like, a little after 10. So yeah, I just went to bed because it was a long day of socializing. But yeah, had a good time. Today I'm heading to the Tellurian to do some work on my practicum, and I'm quite pleased with my outfit today. I feel like I look like I'm, you know, at a Florida resort or something, but yeah, gonna head out there and get some stuff done. So to check in, I worked at the Tellurian for quite a while, and but in that time we had the digital editions community of practice. So basically there are people that are involved in, like, creating digital editions or who are doing work on it, come and give a presentation. So it's arranged by one of the leads on my practicum, And today there was a PhD student who is like encoding this really long French document that was talking about encoding abbreviations. So it was interesting. Yeah, so we went to that talk in between all the work I was doing on my practicum stuff. So yeah, had a good day, and then I came back and chilled out for a bit. And now one of our friends from Pembroke is an MBA, and a bunch of the MBAs have a band called Business Casual, which I think is really funny. And they are performing tonight, so we're going to go see them at the Jericho Tavern, which is in Jericho, which is a bit of a walk from us, but it's like 30 minutes, but I'm really excited to see them perform because they performed at the Taylor Swift Ball and were really good, so it'll be nice to see like a fuller show from them. So yeah, should be a fun night. At the Jericho Tavern was really, really fun. Michael killed it. Seeing the band perform was so fun because I've only seen a very mini set at the Taylor Swift Ball, so getting to see them perform more was really fun. And they performed a lot of Taylor Swift songs because they were like, we were preparing for the Taylor Swift Ball, so now half our set list is Taylor Swift. But I'm not complaining. And Emma Watson was there. So we came in and we were just like waiting for the show to start, and it was really loud and you couldn't really hear each other. So I'm just like scanning the crowd and I was like, that's a really beautiful girl. And I was like, that's Emma Watson. And I hope I was pretty subtle. I had one friend standing over here and then a couple friends over here. So I like turned my back to Miss Emma Watson and I went up to my friend and I was like, that's Emma Watson over there. And then I went over to my other friends and I was like, Emma Watson's here. And they were very subtle. They didn't go like, so I don't think that it was too obvious, but yeah, she was there. She had a dog. She's gorgeous in person. Yeah, that's my first spotting. Cause I feel like everyone, whenever she comes up, people are like, oh yeah, I saw her. Like I was walking down the street and I saw her walking by Blackwell's. Like a lot of people have like Emma Watson spotted stories now because obviously like she's here and she's studying. So like, you're gonna see her around, but I have not seen her yet. So yeah, that is very cool. And I was like, I played it so cool, but like, yeah, I wasn't gonna go up to her because I feel like, I don't know, it just seems, especially like, I feel like it'd be one thing if like, you were both in a bookstore or in a cafe or something and you're like both waiting in line and she's alone and you're alone and you go up, but when it's like, if she was there with like a group of friends and then you just like are like, hi, like it's, I don't know, I was trying to play it cool. But yeah, it's very exciting. Apparently she's gonna be at the Rhodes Ball tomorrow, so maybe I'll actually get to meet her. But yeah, I don't think that I would be brave enough to just, because I don't want to like go bug her. I don't want to be that guy, you know, have to play it cool. But yeah, so now I have my celebrity sighting moment. I've never like actually met or like seen a celebrity out and about before, so yeah, now I have. But today it's sunny out again and I have a bunch of like reading to do, but like reading a book to do for my dissertation and stuff. So Eloise and I are gonna go have another picnic like we did last weekend and kind of take advantage of the sunshine, so should be a nice afternoon. Please ignore everything that I have going on here. I just wanted to check in and like kind of recap the day yesterday because I didn't really fill in on what I was doing as I was doing it. There was no narration. But basically, Eloise and I went to Christchurch Meadows and we had a little mini picnic and read for a while. I was reading a book and she was reading these articles that her dissertation supervisors had given her. And she said she hasn't had to read that many, like, bio articles before. She's doing maths, but it's more, like, bio-maths, I guess. Like, they're doing stuff with, I think for her dissertation, she's looking at stuff about, like, I think it was modeling tumors and tumor growth. Yeah, very cool stuff. I do not understand most of it or how you do it, but very cool. And, so she was reading these articles, and she was like, Cass, this is how they described killing the mice, and it's like, and then when the mice were sacrificed, we took out their livers, and it's just, like, funny the way that they phrase stuff to make it sound a little less gruesome, but yeah. So we were reading that, and then the cows are back in Christchurch Meadows, so we had to go say hi to the cows, because, basically there's, like, a little field that the Meadows paths are kind of built around, and when we first got here, there was cows out there. It's a pasture in Christchurch. Owns a small cow herd, and it's so funny because I'll hear people being like, did you hear that Christchurch, like, sometimes they'll butcher one of their own cows and that's like the beef that they serve in hall, which I don't know if they like eat their own beef, but whenever people tell me that, I'm like, yeah, like, what do you think happens to cows anywhere? Like, why is this shocking, basically? But yeah, so we saw the cows and there were some babies out there, so that was cute. And then we went and walked around for a little bit just around the city, and then I took her to Rhodes House because I had to pick up my wristband for the ball tonight, so I gave her a little tour. We came back and we walked through university parks, and it was really just to kill time until it was a reasonable time of day to go and get Kokoro. Because we went and got dinner and then went to Pembroke and just, like, ate in the quad and sat there for a long time. Because it was so nice out yesterday. So we just had another little mini picnic. And then we were, like, lying in the grass and Gaia walked by and she's like, thanks for the invite. And we're like, we thought you were busy all day. Which she was invigilating. So she joined us for a bit and then we came back and watched Romancing the Stone, which was obviously my suggestion. It's such an underrated movie. So we came back and watched that in the evening and then called it a night. So yeah, it was a really, really nice day yesterday. Today it's also quite sunny, but I haven't been out yet because I have this thing in my head. Because Rhodes Ball is tonight, so I'm going to be heading to that. I'm super excited for it. They've sent out the dinner menu, which looks really good. And then they also have like an open bar and everything, and all the drinks have like Phantom of the Opera themed names because the ball is Phantom of the Opera themed. I think it's gonna be a really, really fun night, so I'm very excited for that. Yeah, so it should be a cool evening. Okay, hello again, guys. So I just finished, I'm getting ready like way too early for this, like way too early, but I was just bored and sitting around, so I was like, why don't I just start my makeup? So I'm done my makeup. I'm also, I think, going to do like a bright pink lip, but since it's Phantom of the Opera, I was like, oh, it should be like dramatic and gothy. So I was like, I'll do a darker eye, which I didn't, it's not particularly dark, but I really like how it looks. So yeah, I think I'm gonna do like half up, half down with my hair, because I like the idea of like having it down and like really curly, but sometimes it's irritating when it gets in your face, and so it's just, like, easier. And then I have this little cameo necklace that I got from, it's, like, in Selenicast, I'm not sure how to pronounce it. I was like, this could be a scam. I got ads for it all the time. So I ordered this, and then I ordered like my berry jewelry that I was gonna wear to the fantasy ball to try to make my pink dress a little more fairy-ish, which obviously that ball got canceled. But that jewelry is pretty like wearable. Like I wear that stuff day to day. Yeah, so I've got my little cameo, and yeah, so then I've recruited some friends to help me do up the laces on the back of my dress, and then we're going to go, and I think maybe go to Pembroke, and they're going to help me take a couple pictures, because I know that there is a photo booth there, but, like, I wasn't able to get a guest ticket, so I'm not, like, going with anyone specifically, so then I feel like it's just kind of harder to be like, hey, someone, please take a photo of me. So, yeah. And then we'll get some, like, out in the light and everything. So I think it'll be good. But, yeah.
Here is, like, a shot of my face in perhaps better light. Yeah, it looks really good now. We'll see if it looks good by the time I have to leave since I did it way too early. But, yeah. I'm excited.
Okay, so I've just got the dress on. My friend Gaia is coming up to help me do it up because, so picture it cinched in like that. My hair didn't exactly do what I wanted it to do, but I think it looks okay. So yeah, I'm so excited. I'll get a better shot outside so you can see the whole thing. But yeah, I'm so excited.
So it is Sunday now. I think I got a few decent clips of the Rhodes Ball and it was super fun. We came in and they immediately started plying us with a lot of champagne. So one of the waiters, when he came to top me up, I was like, yeah, sure. And he was like, I love the enthusiasm. And I was like, this is how I know that I have had too much. But it was really, really fun. We came in, had like the champagne reception, and they were walking around with some appetizers, which were really good. I had absolutely no clue what they were, but they were delicious. And yeah, it was really fun to catch up with everybody and see everybody all dressed up. They had like a full red carpet as we were waiting to go in, had the champagne toast. Then they filtered us in for dinner. And like a couple of the girls that were on the ball planning committee were giving a speech. And then at the end, they like had a strobe going on. It's not really a chandelier, but it's like an installation, like that thing. They had a strobe going on it, and then we're playing like dun, 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 like the music from Phantom of the Opera. It was very good. All of the details were very on point. The committee did a really, really great job. So we had dinner, which was good, and then headed down for, they had like a little mini kind of cocktail mixer and a dessert bar downstairs while they cleared out all the tables and chairs to open up the main space to be a dance floor again. So once that was all filled up, we went back upstairs and yeah, had like, they had a live band for a little while and then it switched to a DJ. So it was a lot of fun, had a really, really good time. And yeah, very nice to see everybody and catch up. So that was very fun. But this morning, I was naturally feeling a little fragile, so I didn't get up to anything too exciting today. But one thing that was kind of cool is I did a Instagram Live / podcast with someone, which like I've never been asked to do before, on Bookstagram. So I'll link her Instagram account below, because she has the live, I think, saved and posted to her profile, so you should still be able to watch it. And I think she's going to post the audio from the live as a podcast, so if that's up when this video goes up, I'll link that as well. Basically, this other bookstagrammer also studied, her name's Chloe, she also studied English as an undergrad at the University of Birmingham. So we were just kind of talking and comparing our experiences and talking about being on Bookstagram and then also studying English and everything. So that was a really, really cool thing to do, because like I said, I've never been asked to do anything like that before, so that was really, really fun, and it was cool to kind of compare our experiences. So yeah, that should be up now, but other than that, I've just been, you know, doing my thing today, so I think I'm going to end the video here, and I'll see you guys in the next one.